Hello students, welcome to Shore Observe classes. My name is Professor Himadri Datta. In today's lecture, we'll continue our discussion on IAS 2015 question paper. So it is general economics paper number 1. So today we'll be focusing on section B, question number 5. So the question number 5 goes like this. So we'll be focusing on section B, question number 5. So the question number 5 goes like this. The consumption function is given by C equals to 20 plus 0.75 YD. So I'll write down the things which are given on the right hand side so that we can use it in order to find the required question. Okay, so the consumption function is given by C equals to 200 plus 0.75 YD. So the consumption function is given by 200 plus 0.75 YD. Now the investment function is given by I equals to 400 minus 50 I. Investment function is given by 400 minus 50 I. I equals to 400 minus 50 I. And government purchases is given by G is given by 200. And tax is given by 0.2y. Now L, which is the real demand for money, is given by 0.5 minus 75i. And nominal money supply, which is MS, is given by 900. Now YD stands for disposable income, Y income, and I interest rate. So disposable income is nothing but income minus tax. So we have all this information in our hand. So now we will proceed to the questions. So now the first question goes like this. Estimate the equation for IS curve and LM curve. Now what is the equation for IS curve? If you know, the equation for IS curve goes like this. Y equals to C plus I plus G. Now here the C is given by 200 plus 0.75 YD. Now instead of YD, which is disposable income, we can write Y minus T. Plus investment is given by 400 minus 50 I. Plus government expenditure is given by 200. So now we have all these informations, and we'll put the value of G and put the value of T here. So if you put the value of T here, we'll find it to be Y minus 0.2Y plus 400 minus 50I plus 200. Now, if you solve this, you know 200, 400, 200 becomes 800 plus this becomes 0.75Y and this becomes minus 0.75 y minus 0.2 y is 0.8 y equals to plus minus, sorry, minus 50 i. So we have found it to be like this. So we have found it to be 800 plus 0.75 into 0.8y. Now if you solve this equation, we'll find the value of y to be equals to 800 plus 0.6y minus 50i. So we have found the value of y to be equals to 800 plus 0.6y minus 50i. Now what we will do, we'll take the 0.6y on the left hand side. So if you take this on the left hand side, what will happen? I'll rub this off so that I can rewrite it. Now, y will be equals to 800 plus 0.6y will come left hand side. So it will become y minus 0.6y, which is nothing but 0.4y minus 50i. Now if you solve, if you take 0.4i, this side, if you divide 800 minus 5i, 50i, by 0.4, then we'll get the value of y to be equals to 2000 minus 125i. Now we have found the value of y to be 2000 minus 125i. Now this is nothing but the IS equation. So this is nothing but the IS equation. So what we have done? So we have taken C plus I plus G. Now value of yd is nothing but y minus t. Now value of t is given. Now if you solve this value, all these equations, you will get the value of y to be 2000 minus 125i. So this is our finding, which we'll write down here on the right hand side. So this is our finding, which we'll write down here on the right hand side. Y equals to 2000 minus 125i. Now here we are also asked to find the value of the IS equation and also the LM equation. Now you know the LM equation talks about the equilibrium in money market. So the equilibrium in money market is real money supply, which is money supply by price equals to money demand price, which is the real demand for money. So when money demand is equals to money supply, we say the money market is in equilibrium. So here the money market is in equilibrium. So from here we'll find the LM equation. So now you see the demand is given by 0.5. This demand is given by 0.5, as is given 0.75i. 0.5 minus 75i. And money supply is given by 900 divided by price. Now this price will be here. Now if you try to find the value of I, then say this will come on the left hand side, so it will become 0.5 minus 75i equals to, so we are redoing it. So now if you this take this side, this thing will be left with 75i. Okay, so we are done with this. Now if you proceed further with this, if you solve this equation, we'll find the value of I to be equals to 0.5 divided by 175, 0.5 divided by 75 minus 12 by p. So if you solve this, we'll find the value of I to be 0.5 divided by 75 minus 12 by p. So we'll write down what our finding is. I equals to 0.5 75 minus 12 by p. So we have find this is nothing but the LM equation. Now from here what we'll do is, so this is the LM equation. Now we'll try to put the value of I here in this. Now we'll put the value of I here and we'll find the value of y to be equals to 2000, which is like this, minus 125 into 0.5 by 75 minus 12 by p. Now if you solve this, we'll get 2000 minus 0.8 minus 1500 by p. So now if you keep on solving it, we'll get 9992 minus 150 by 2. So this is nothing but the aggregate demand curve. Aggregate demand curve. See, in LM equation, we could not find any relationship between interest rate and income. The way we found it in case of IS, we did not find it in case of LM. But so what we had to do is, we had to put the value of I here to find the aggregate demand curve. So aggregate demand curve, which is YE, equals to 1999.2 minus 150 by 2. Sorry, it will be 150 by p. So we have found the aggregate demand curve. Now what we have to do is, we have to equate this aggregate demand curve with aggregate supply curve to get the equilibrium level of interest rate and income. So now what we'll do, we'll look into the other question in this. So first question was estimate the equation for IS curve and LM curve. Therefore, solve the system for equilibrium level of real income and real interest rate. So we have found the value, the equation for IS curve, which was negatively sloped. As you can see, IS curve, the relationship between Y and I is negative, and the relationship between LM, the relationship between Y and R in case of LM curve, we could not find. We just found the value of I here. So LM curve is basically will be a horizontal sloped curve. So, and here what we are supposed to do, we have to find the system for equilibrium level of real income and real interest rate. In order to find the equilibrium level of real income and real interest rate, what we have to do is we have to first equate these two in order to get the aggregate demand curve. Now, when aggregate demand curve is equals to aggregate supply curve, we say we have got the equilibrium level of real income and real interest rate. Now, in the next question, it is given that suppose the government purchases an increase from 200 to 300. Now, suppose the government has increased its purchase from 200 to 300. Estimate the change in income. Now, what will be the change in income? Has there been any crowding out of private investment? Represent information graphically. Okay, so now what we'll do is we'll simply change the value of 200 by 300. So then we'll find the IS equation to be like this. So you know the IS equation is nothing but consumption plus investment plus government expenditure. So the consumption is given by 200 plus 0.75 YD, which is Y minus T, plus I, which is 400 minus 50 I, and government expenditure has increased to 300. Now tax is given by 0.2 Y, so we can write it this way. Now if you keep on solving this equation, see 200, 400 and 300 will become 900, plus this will become Y minus 0.8 Y minus 50 I. Now it will become, if you multiply this with this, it will become 0.6 Y minus 50 I. Now if you take 0.6 Y on the left hand side, it will become Y minus 0.6 Y equals to 900 minus 50 I. So Y will be equals to 900 minus 50 I divided by 0.4, which is equals to Y equals to 2250. If you solve this, you will get this 125 I. So this is nothing but the new IS equation. So this is the IS equation, which is new. Now, in order to find the change in income, what we have to do is, we already know the initial income level in the previous period. Now, in this, income will be in equilibrium, the income will be, which is Y, will be equals to this, we'll put the value of I here. So we will get 2250 minus 125. Instead of I, we will write 0.5 by 75 minus 12 by P. We will get it to be like this. Now what we have to do is, we will simply solve it. 2250 minus 0.8 minus 1500 by P, which will be equals to 2249 minus by P. Now, so this is our new income level. as compared to what we have found in case of, in the earlier case where the income level was, the earlier case the income, this is the new income level, in earlier case the income level was 1999.2 minus, if you refer to the earlier section of this video, you'll be able to understand why I've taken Y naught to be like this. Now, in order to find the change in income, this is very simple. The change in income you'll be able to find when you take Y1 minus Y naught. This is Y1 minus Y naught. If you do this, you'll find the value to be 250. That is, if you subtract this by this, you'll get it to be 250. So the income increases by 200 units. So the, when government expenditure increases by 100 units, when government expenditure, I'll write it here, income or Y increases by 250 units. So it is a multiplier effect. So far what we have done, in the earlier section of the video, the consumption equation, the investment equation, the government expenditure is given. From there we have found IS equation first, then money demand and money supply, real money supply is given. We had to equate this together to find the LM equation. Now in the LM equation, we couldn't find any direct relationship between Y and R. So simply we have found the LM equation to be I equals to 0.5 by 75 minus 12 by P. Now, so we have put this value of I in the IS equation to find the aggregate demand curve. So from there we have found the aggregate demand curve first. Now, if the aggregate supply curve is given, which is not in case of this question, then we have to equate these two to get the equilibrium level of income and interest rate. So we are done with the first part. Now in the second part, they have asked, if the government expenditure, which was 200, now increased to 300, what will be its effect on the income level? So for this, again, you have to write the IS equation, that is C plus I plus G. There you have to change the government expenditure by 100 units. Now if you do this, you will get an IS equation. Now in that IS equation, you will plot the value of I, which is the LM equation, interest rate. If you put it, you will get another Y, which is different from what you have got in the earlier case. Now if you compare this two Y, we will get the change in income due to increasing government expenditure. You will find it to be 250, which we have found it here. So our conclusion is that when government expenditure increases by 100, which is 200 to 300, the income increases by 250 units. So we are almost done with this question. Now we have another question to address, and which is a very important one. That is, has there been any crowding out of private investment? How will we find it? So in order to do it, first we have to draw the LM curve and IS curve. Now, so we'll draw the LM and IS curve. Here we'll write our interest rate, here we'll write income. We'll draw the IS curve, which is 16 or 2000. As you can see here, either it is 16 or 2000. And also we can write another IS equation, which is 2250. So first, in the first case it was 2000, now it is 2250, and you can see from the IS equation that the IS curve, this is nothing but IS curve, is negatively sloped because of this negative sign. Now in case of LM curve, as we have already talked about, we could not find any direct relationship between income and interest rate, which is the essence of LM curve. So here in this case, LM curve will be horizontally sloped, that is, a horizontal curve is a LM curve. So now here, as you can see, LM curve cuts IS curve at this level, we'll call it Y naught, and at this level we'll call it Y1. So here, as you can see, when income increases, as the LM curve is horizontally slope, the income, there is no crowding out. So as you can see, income increases here, but there is no crowding out. So we'll conclude our discussion today with the conclusion that there is no crowding out of private investment due to this. I hope you guys have liked this video. If you not, or if you have any query or doubt, confusion or suggestion, I'll be giving you my number, which is 9836793076. You can directly WhatsApp me on this number, which is 9836793076, or you can also go to our website, which is www.shourabsirclasses.com. There you will find a lot of other videos like this, and you will find a lot of other materials for Indian Economic Service exam. So today we'll talk about Indian Economic Service 2015 paper, General Economics, paper 1, section B, question number. Today we talked about the question number 6. Question number 5 from section B, from paper 1. In the next subsequent video, we'll continue our discussion on IES 2015. Thank you for watching the video. Have a nice day ahead.